Welcome to part 2, The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom, on the Nintendo Switch. I wasn't planning to do a part 2 on this, but I really didn't have any games ready to do. It's kind of unprepared because it's been a pretty busy week, so last minute I just thought, well, I already have this game on my Switch. Now, I'm not continuing from where I left off in the last video. I have played a little bit all week, like maybe an hour every day. Barely had some time to play, so got a little bit further, but just thought I'd go ahead and show some more of the game, and so now I'm a little bit more used to some of the new ideas put into the game. So I'm no longer on the island in the sky. So to beat the island in the sky, you have to beat 4 shrines. It's kind of like Breath of the Wild, where you have to get the 4 shrines in the Great Plateau region. Once you get those, four shrines, you get the paraglider. That didn't necessarily happen in this game. In this game, you get the 4 shrines and you end up down in the back in the Hyrule field. So it's kind of nice to be back in the kind of familiar territory. But then it took a little bit before I got the paraglider. So I'm just going to kind of run around. You can still see the island in the sky if you look up in certain areas. There it is. Yeah, see, I thought that part of the game was really hard because navigating around that wasn't easy. There was a lot of like, climbing and descending without the paraglider. Let's go get that tower. Oh. Let's not let that guy see me. And I cannot find a shirt. I went to Kakariko Village just to check it out. And I went to Hatino Village hoping to get my soldier's armor, which I had gotten in Breath of the Wild, but that armor shop is no longer there. So for the most part, the terrain is pretty much the same, but there have been some changes. I mean, you gotta remember, you gotta remember now that Link got rid of Ganon in the last game. Oh, here's one thing that annoys me. You have to press the A button to take. Where in the last game you just touched it. I don't know what that thing is, but I don't want it to see me. But I forgot what I was talking about now. Yeah, so see, like in the last game, you had runes like the that's crazy. Yeah, you had the bombs, you had Magnesis, Cryonis, and Stasis. Here you have got So the hand, you pick up objects up, you can attach them. This one, you can go through like the ceilings of stuff. I forgot what that one is. That one's like makes things go backwards. I really haven't figured out how to use Fuse yet. See, I've been trying to. My goal has kind of been to go around and get all the towers first. But I notice a lot of them are way up high and I can't reach them. Oh, great. Thank you. So I finally find a tower. And I can't unlock it. You don't have to climb in this game normally. You just go inside the door. The shrines seem to be a lot harder in this game. I don't think this is gonna work. I don't have any stamina power-ups. Wait a minute, can I rest up here? Almost every shrine I tried, I couldn't figure out. I had to look up a YouTube video on it. You know, on the last, last game, Breath of the Wild, I mean, there were some shrines I had to look up, couldn't figure out, but for the most part, I was able to figure out a lot of them. So I'm pretty sure once I get to the top, I can glide through a hole up there, if I can make it all the way up there. I don't think I have any stamina meals. No, I don't. See, in Breath of the Wild, you didn't need stamina to climb a tower. Oh, wow. Great. I can't go down there either. See, it's not as explanatory in this game. Like, he says he can't get in, but see, now in Breath of the Wild, he probably would have explained to me why he can't get in and what I have to do to get in there. Oh, that's a stone talus with an enemy fort on top of it. I've seen one of those before. Now, where did that come from? Or not. Well, if you're gonna cheat, then I'm not gonna play with you. Oh yeah, anyways, this is a thing what I forgot about is after Link got rid of Ganon, people of Hyrule started rebuilding, so there's some differences in the game. Right when I got to Hyrule Field, I recognized Riverside Stable right away. Here's something new you could do is build stuff. Showing how you build stuff. I guess you could build a wagon. Still have the shield serpent. See if I can find a shrine. I'd like to know what those things are falling from the sky. There's a stable. Probably already been to that stable. What's cool is your horses are still in the game from Breath of the Wild. Whatever horses you had in the stable in Breath of the Wild will be in this game too. The same two horses, well, however many horses you have. But I had two horses in Breath of the Wild. I named them Miyamoto and Yamauchi. There's one thing I don't like about the game is the music. The battle music. I thought Breath of the Wild had good battle music. Yeah, they got Hylian tomatoes in this game, which we didn't see in Breath of the Wild. Beetle's still in this game. This with monster parts for stamina. Not much. Like, I really want to try this. Sticky frog. Slip resistance. I think that's what they forgot to add to Breath of the Wild. I think the climbing gear was supposed to be slip resistance. They forgot to add it or something. I'm gonna go get one of my horses out and see if we can ride to a shrine or something. Actually, I think I went that way last time. Let's go the other way. There's a shrine I did. So yeah, the old shrines from Breath of the Wild are no longer existent in this game. They got new shrines. And they're not in the exact same spots. That I've already gotten. Most of Hyrule looks pretty familiar though. I tried to figure out how to pull a wagon. Whoa. It just like just appeared out of nowhere. Maybe we should head south. I already tried this tower down here. Yeah, I went up to Rito Village too, and that's where they kind of sent me on a mission, but at that point I decided I want to unlock all the towers first. So let's go down here, I'll try to unlock this one. This seems like just about every tower I see is up on like a high mountain. The towers are also in different locations. They're not in the exact same spots as they were in the last game. And it's weird, Central Tower in the last game was like the hardest one to unlock. There are guardians around it. I have not seen any guardians in this game. Central Tower was the first one I unlocked. Now there's a village right around it. Like a small village. See, there's tower right there on top of a mountain. I I got that shrine up there on top of that thing way up there in the air. Pin that so I won't lose it if it ends up getting out of sight. How deep is that water? It's kind of annoying I don't have my bombs or my stasis or my magnesis, all the stuff I used to use all the time. Breath of the Wild, I don't have any of that. Uvali scale. You think Link would have kept all that stuff. But you don't have a Sheikah Slate in this game, you have the Kura pad. Sounds like a name brand for a maxi pad or something. Now I can try out my new climbing potion, or whatever you want to call it, elixir. I also haven't seen the Divine Beast either. I went to Rito Village, I did not see Bob Meadow. Not gonna even let me activate it. See, another one has something wrong with every single tower. I'm guessing I'm supposed to complete whatever mission I'm on before I can get the rest of the towers. Flower. Well, it's something to do anyway. But am I really going to be able to get back up out of here? Cave entrance over this way. Maybe they'll let me in the tower. Hey, what's that? Treasure chest. Oops, wrong one. Is this button to open that too? Thank you. power exams it. There's the Sky Island. From what I heard, there's also an underground, like, map. That's what one of my co-workers told me. Okay, I don't know what the purpose of this thing is. So my only purpose of this video is just to kind of explain what I liked about the game so far and what I don't like, and also just kind of show what this part of the game looks like. I really don't plan on doing any more videos of this game until I'm able to beat it, then I'll do a full playthrough of it. Oh, I remember this location. This is where I got the captured memory. Yeah, there's still Korok seeds in this game. I'm not sure if there's 900 like there were in the last game. That's actually the third one I got. I already gave one to Hestu. Expanded my weapon stash. I have not seen the Great Plateau region yet in this game. Which is where I wish they would have dropped me off at when I first made it off the Sky Island. That would have been kind of cool. Yeah, I usually record my videos the weekend before I upload them. I just did not have any time. We're currently working 48 hours a week, and rumor has it we might be going on to 56 hours a week. Well, I hope not. I don't know what the black and red stuff is, but it can't be good. I did see something black and red. There were a bunch of arms reaching out for me, so I ran like a frightened little girl. There's a hole down there. I think I'm gonna go over and get the shrine first, and I might come back and check that out. don't have much luck down there, and I guess a good point to end the video. I'd really like to know why these are falling. Is there something I'm supposed to do with them? Now where'd that shrine go? I should have placed a pin on it. Yeah, so happy when I got the paraglider. It was so annoying on that Sky Island. There's all these ways down. I couldn't figure out how to get down in half those spots. I hope this one's easy to figure out. Yeah, I'm using his undies. Great. What am I supposed to do? Sitting there gang raping me. Idiots. Great, no food. What if I die? You know what? I'm leaving this place. It's the first time I've left a shrine in this game without beating it. And the difficulty is just way too hard in this game. I'll do a different shrine. Why do my hearts go up though? It's down to like one and a half hearts. I got an idea. Let's just look for a shrine by going to the top of a tower. Go to Retail Village. Wait. Yeah, I think a little regional village looks a little different than Breath of the Wild. I mean, not a whole lot different, but there's snow all over it. Front entrance, Rito Village, didn't have the snow in it for Breath of the Wild. I guess spirit orbs do. I guess they're called Light of Blessings in this game, but I still need one more. At 500 rupees, I don't have enough. Maybe I got stuff to sell her. Okay, what can I sell? Yeah, see, I'm not gonna have enough to get up to. Do this, but well, there now I got snow pants and a snow shirt. The cold resistance, I guess. At least I finally got a top. Yeah, finding rupees seemed a lot easier, or getting rupees seemed a lot easier in Breath of the Wild. But then again, I keep forgetting that I played that game so many times, I know where to find everything. I've learned a lot of different tricks and stuff. There's Tiba. What's that tower out there? That's this one. Are there any other shrines? See, apparently the reason it's snowing, I talked to Pura, whatever her name is. She told me that there's weird phenomena in different parts of Hyrule. Regional phenomena. in these locations. One of them's in Retail Village. And so the phenomena here is the snow. I guess this is not normal here, which we all know from playing Breath of the Wild, so I'm supposed to solve the mystery. Apparently solve the other mysteries. But I started to, and then it got kind of confusing. I thought, well, I just want to unlock all the towers first. So that's what I started doing. Going off looking for towers, and then I decided to check out Kakariko Village. I was curious if it was all the same and that. Then decided to go to Hatino Village. I was hoping to buy the Soldier's Armor. And it turned out they don't have it. Oh, the pine cones are pretty cool. You can use that to create an updraft, light it on fire. Those are always fun to do. Yeah, see, I couldn't figure out how to get into Rito Village when I first got here because the bridge is broken. And then I talked to that girl up here and she mentioned something about the pine cones creating an updraft, so I tried one and I was able to fly over there. That's a long way up there. There's a shooting star. I've already had two blood moons since I've been flying. Like a cave. Actually, I think this is the cave I normally go through in Breath of the Wild. It's got like all these alphas in there. Kind of like Hatino Tower in the last game. Yeah, I haven't found any fire arrows, bomb arrows, or ice arrows. But I've been shooting that fire fruit, and it works kind of like... Now, I think there's a way you could fuse the fire fruit with an arrow to shoot a flame arrow, but I haven't figured out how to do that yet. See, I'll show... I set one of these down. I put an arrow down on the ground. Go to fuse. It goes to the fire fruit. Actually, no, my ball broke, so maybe I have to equip another ball. See, it only... give me the option to fuse it to my pot lid or my boulder hammer. Okay, hopefully this rings easier. Launching device. Oh, that's messed up. I don't want to throw it that far. I'm trying to get the land. Rocket. Oh, they respawn. Cool. Down. They really screwed the thing up, didn't they? Oops. See, I keep forgetting about the fact that you can attach things. Thank you. pretty cool. So now that shrine wasn't too hard to figure out. It might also just be the fact that I'm getting older and more impatient. Someone just replied on my comment on a post from 8 years ago on the Nintendo Entertainment System fan page. It's kind of crazy. Okay, let's go to Kakariko Village to get my heart container. I didn't get the shrine in Tino Village. Tino Ancient Tech Lab, and there was a note on the door from Robbie that said it could be located on the center, by the front of where the castle was. Apparently there is a way to unlock the gate. The travel gate, I just don't know how to do it. See, in Breath of the Wild, the shrine is up there somewhere. Most of this village looks pretty much the same except for that weird stuff up there. I tried to go up there and they wouldn't let me. Yeah, so I guess there are some changes. I guess it's different. Paya, she's now in charge of the village, I guess. Impa retired. So I don't know if there's really anywhere else to go or anything else to do. Okay, so Why does it say Faerun right there? Usually the Faerun region was over here. I think. Yeah, because this is... Lake Tower was down here. This was the lake region. Then you had Faerun. This is the Akala region. Let's go north. Might be kind of cool. Check out the grounds of Hyrule Castle. Yeah, so this hand kind of acts as magnesis, except for it doesn't, it's not just metal objects you can pick up, it's a lot of things. Crazy, the water's just stopping. Wish I had the Zora's armor. I'm curious if Ganon's gonna make a return in this game at some point, because Ganon's always been the main enemy of the game. It would be cool though if they had different enemies in every Mario and Zelda game. Get more interesting. Because I mean, like, for example, the James Bond movies, not always the same bad guy. Whoa. Goodies to cook up. Doesn't seem to be much to see around here. I've been finding this everywhere, like. They really want me to go away. Whoa, I pressed the button to glide. I kind of missed the Guardians, actually. I already got the shrine, I don't remember getting that one. Oh yeah, I do. That might have been the first shrine I got. Awesome. When I made it to Hyrule. Well, I'm going to take this, go back up to this tower. I'm going to look down here for shrines, and then it's going to be about the end of it for today. Next week, it'll be a different game. Something retro, and in 2 weeks, the next hockey game. seeing any shrines around. Oh, I forgot to mention, there's enemies in this game that are trees. Sometimes you'd be passing by a tree and it'll just get up and start walking towards you. It'll attack you. Built for rails. Something tells me this isn't a good idea. It's probably gonna fall like the other one did. Okay, what are you supposed to do here? Thank you. mean, they don't give you any clues on what to do. You're just supposed to guess. I'm assuming it needs some weight on this side. Or not. I mean, what do you need a degree in physics to figure out exactly how to build this thing so it doesn't fall? Well, that was part 2 of Breath of the Wild, Tears of the Kingdom. Hope you enjoyed it. See you in the next video.